So let's have a deeper look at CSS sizing. I've given this image a fixed size, 640 by 360 pixels, which is the natural size of the image. It looks great, but of course, when I resize the window, the image gets cropped. And remember the problem we had earlier. On a phone, the image is larger than the viewport, which means that to see the whole image, you have to scroll horizontally. Let's try relative sizing. I set the image width to 100%. It looks good in the smaller browser window and looks good on the phone. But when I resize the image larger, by resizing the browser window, it starts to get pixelated and blurry. Let's do something about that. If we set the max width of the image to 100%, the image will expand nicely, but only ever as wide as its natural width. Two simple things you can learn from this. For devices such as laptops and desktop monitors, don't assume the window size is the same as the screen size. And don't assume the window size will always stay the same. Using max width can be a good way to respond gracefully to a change to a larger viewport. When you're thinking responsively, consider large displays as well as small. So what if you want two images to fit side by side, no matter the size of the viewport? Well, that's easy. Just use relative sizing, 50% width. But what if you want to add a 10 pixel margin between the images? You can just add margin right, 10 pixels, right? You can get around this with our old friend, Calc. Calc allows you to do simple calculations and CSS values, and that's a great way to combine absolute and relative values. For example, combining a percentage width with a fixed margin. Now, the calculation here looks a little complex, but all we're saying is to give each image a half of the width available. I've also used the last of type selector to ensure there's only a margin between the images and none to the right of the second image.